Hey guys, welcome to my channel. I'm Tony, and in this video, Rob the Plumber and I are going to put a toilet onto a toilet flange. We'll show you how to put the wax ring on and set the toilet on the toilet flange and bolt it all down in case you don't know how to. But before we get going, remember, if you like the video, give it a thumbs up and leave a comment if you have a question, and we'll answer them for you.
Alright, so before you set the toilet down, what do we need to do, Rob?
Alright, well, we made sure the surface was all clean.
Yep.
We're just going to use this ring for now, because obviously we're going to take it back off to finish the floor and stuff. And basically just make sure this sits nice and flat on here in the middle. And okay. Then
there's like this rubber piece right here. The people have never done this. Let me grab my light so we can see better. Obviously need the cone pointing down inside the PVC pipe or the cast pipe if you have cast.
Yep.
So right now, we're going to attach some screws, and that's going to anchor the toilet to this flange right here.
Yep.
So you should have either a cast or a PVC flange. We're doing a whole bunch of new stuff to this bathroom. We have a cement floor that we just put down. So we're down one toilet. So right now we're going to get the other toilet up and running, and we need to peel it back off before we put the vinyl floor down. But to get us through for a little while until we're able to do that, get another toilet up and running, we're going to put this one on. So you're going to want to set your two screws.
These you want off your wall, 12 and a half center to center. That's your normal toilet setting. Sweet. Which I already put marks on the floor.
Okay.
Marked it out so I can just line this up.
So then on those two studs sticking up, looks like there's a couple of screws like right there. So you can tighten up on those screws so that the studs don't move around on you, right?
Yep, that's just to keep it in place. You don't have to crank them down. They just
to help keep it in place.
Yep.
While you set the toilet on.
And now we can go find the toilet.
Okay. And we'll set it in place. Okay, so now we're going to set the toilet onto the wax ring and the flange. Rob, is there anything we should be careful of when you're doing this? What's the best way to do it?
Just make sure you got the line up with the tools on the toilet here. I mean, it's easy to do with this without putting it together, put it together after. Just set it down nice and easy.
Yep.
Line up each hole. There's my hole right there. Give it a little pressure. All right.
Now, when you tighten up on those bolts, is it going to kind of suck the back of the toilet in down?
Yep, you got to not really crank them.
Because you don't want to break the porcelain, right?
Nope. And you're going to be putting another floor under it.
Right.
So you don't have to crank it.
Yep.
Usually you just sit on it yourself to push it down.
Put a little bit of body weight to it.
Yes. I don't think you're going to have to use these caps. I like these caps the longer.
Yeah, there you go.
Alright.
So now we're going to bolt this in place. So there's two screws. There'll be one on the side that we can see, and there'll be one on the other side. So right now, Rob's doing funny stuff. So you're putting your body weight on the toilet so you can kind of compress that wax ring, right?
Yes.
Okay.
It's kind of cold right now, so it's a little stiff.
Yep.
But
so this kit came with wing nuts, huh?
Yeah. They've been doing that a lot now.
Okay.
Because everyone cranks them down.
And they break the toilet.
It breaks the toilet.
To break the toilet, okay. So, it's going to do the other side.
Yeah, the thing is cold still.
Is it? Yeah, you kind of want to make sure that wax ring is warm. We had it out in the garage. We're in a small bathroom. We're doing a lot of work. But, make sure it's not freezing, and it's pretty much the temperature of the house, right?
Yes.
All right, so we have the toilet secured to the flange. So we're going to keep rolling because we know that these toilets are pretty popular. Now, this happens to be a Glacier Bay toilet. So in order to put the tank top onto the throne, what do we need to do now, Rob?
All right, we're going to put this seal gasket. It goes between the tank and here to seal it. Just basically the kid, you don't want to drop it.
So a lot of these toilets have a similar setup, right?
Yes, they're all basically the same.
Okay. So in case you haven't put a toilet together, we wanted to show you what's involved.
Line it up.
Yep.
I'm going to put your metal washers first.
Okay, so those are going to poke through in the bottom, right?
Yep.
So you have a couple of washers right there.
Let's see if we can get the bottom here. Can you see them in
there? Yeah, kind of. So you have to secure the top of the tank onto the bottom. And again, you don't want to use like a wicked lot of pressure, right, Rob?
No, you only want to put these hand tight. No wrenches. Because you will break.
And the other side's the same way. I can't get in there with the camera because limited space. Alright, so now that the top of the tank is secure, what do we do now?
Oh, we're going to hook up the water supply line.
Okay.
Pretty fairly simple.
Yep. It's just a screw.
It just... No, these are all common size. As long as it says toilet, they'll fit in the toilet. And hand tight. No crazy.
Then once you do that, the next step is to turn the water on, right?
Turn the water on, check the heights. Turn on slow.
Alright, so just open up our valve. We're going to watch the top of the tank fill. And there'll be a float right there, and that'll rise with the water and shut it off and it's up to the level. And you're gonna want to keep an eye like around the bottom of the tank. Make sure there's no leaks around the bottom or anything. Are we looking pretty good?
Looking good.
All right. Let's fill up, and then we'll give it a flush. So it should only take a minute to fill.
Probably less than that.
Full, and now we can test flush it, right?
Test flush.
And hopefully there'll be no leaks.
1.28 liters.
How do we make out?
Looks good. So it's, no leaks.
Hey, so the last thing you do is there are a couple of caps right here, and you can put those like right over the screws on the bottom, and they just kind of pop on. And basically that's it. It's how you connect the toilet to the toilet flange, and just wanted to show you the extra step on how to put these together. Like Rob said, they're all pretty similar to one another. And I hope you liked the video. Take it easy.